This is my mom and me. She passed away in 2004 from ovarian cancer when I was only 8 years old. Because I was young, I don't know much about her. So I interviewed my grandmother, uncle, who was her twin brother, my father, and my brother to get to know a little bit more about her life, who she was, and the impact she had on the people around her.
What was she like as a child?
Well, I think she was obedient. Really, all my kids were, you know, they got along well. I know when I went to work, she was kind of upset about me being gone because she was used to me, you know, like sitting on the bed and rubbing her back and talking to her and stuff like that.
How did she get the name Connie?
Well, my husband was a scout leader and we didn't know we were having twins. It was one of the kids from the scout troop. He suggested it to John, but he came to visit me at the hospital and he said, and I said, what are we going to name these kids? You know, and he said, well, what do you think about Ronnie and Connie? And I thought, oh, that's kind of neat. So that's what we did. She could sing harmony with the RCJ trio. We took their initials, Ronnie, Connie, and Johnny, and made the Rejoicing Children of Jesus and just called them the RCJ trio.
Well, she was the kind of person that when she walks into the room, she just really sets a dynamic in the room. She would kind of lift your spirit. But I do remember times when we would get very tickled and we'd get to laughing so hard that we couldn't hardly breathe. And that even happened one time when we were singing as a trio. Her voice cracked and she started laughing. And so then my brother started laughing and I started laughing and we all three ended the song where we were all three laughing. And this was in a church. Quirks, I don't know, pronouncing words weird. She'd say arl instead of oil. You know, she would butcher the English language sometimes.
How did you and Mom meet?
She was working at Union National Bank with my best friend David Smith's wife, Pam. We were college age. She said, do you know who Connie Henrici is? We'd like you to meet her, and we're kind of thinking about, you know, maybe going on a double date. Oh, a blind date, huh? Ours just happened to go really well. So we met and we dated a year and got married just almost exactly a year after we started dating. We were married a month shy of 26 years. One of the biggest memories, of course, was just how she looked on that day. I mean, when she came down the aisle, I mean, she was just gorgeous.
What was her personality?
Bubbly. She was always laughing. I mean, she had an infectious laugh. I mean, when she'd laugh, everybody'd start laughing. She had a way about her that was just, you enjoyed being with her. And I remember a couple of times we'd actually be in the car on the way to somewhere that we were supposed to be. I'd say, I'm really dreading this, you know? And she'd say, well, we don't have to go. And so a couple of times we just decided to take a detour.
I feel like it's not a day that goes by that I don't think about her in some capacity. But I always remember just like cuddling with her and like taking naps and whatever, relaxing, just kind of like laying my head on her chest or just, you know, hanging out with her or something like that. Usually if she was upset about something, she still was always kind of like happy. And she would sing when she was mad. Like that was always intense. Like she'd get mad and like raise her voice at you and then she'd be like, Noah! Like she'd start singing like vibrato as she's like yelling at you because she's upset.
How did she feel about being sick?
She kind of felt like she was letting everybody down. They gave her basically, the outlook worked out to about 6 months and she ended up lasting about a year and a half. She never lost faith. She never complained. All those girlfriends of hers, they were all rallying around her. It was like a return on the investment.
The thing about it that was so special about her homegoing, I think, was Cindy, her best friend from college, was with her at hospice. And she said that Connie said, ooh, it's so bright in here. And Cindy said, well, you want me to close the blind? So she closed the blind and she came back over to the bed and she said, is that better? And just that moment, she realized she was gone. And, you know, I really believe she saw the lights of heaven. I really do. I know people from the church have told me that they miss her and that what a caring person she was.
She was a girlfriend's girlfriend. The one thing that stands out to me about Connie was never met a stranger. I mean, she made friends with everybody so easy. She was a good friend. to a lot of women.
She lent a very light and humorous dynamic to the family that was very well missed when she was gone.
She always trusted the Lord. She knew she was in His hands, and she loved my dad. That's for sure. It was her time. Like, you know, the Lord had a specific thing on her for this earth to do, and I believe now that she had fulfilled it.
Some of the best times in our past with her were when we were out in the yard, right outside the kitchen window, playing wiffle ball in the yard, and having her come outside and go, "All right, let's go, it's supper, you know, come on in, let's eat." I feel like I had a blessed life with Connie. I'm thankful that she was the mother of my sons.
After interviewing my family, I have come to know that I missed out on knowing a woman who didn't only look beautiful on the outside, but was truly beautiful on the inside. In addition, it is vital that we show our love for our family members because we don't know when they won't be around anymore.